Grooming your horse will help you to keep his coat and hooves in good condition, as well as monitor his health. If you want to keep your horse healthy and happy, you should set a goal to groom him every day. So now on to how to groom your horse. Step one, gather your supplies. You're going to want your rubber curry, your dandy brush, your body brush, your hoof pick, mane and tail brush, detangler, and a towel. Step two, make sure your horse is safely tied up and wearing a leather halter or a breakaway halter. Step three, start with the rubber curry comb. The rubber curry should be used in a circular motion to loosen the dirt that's settled under the horse's hair. Side note, be very careful and gentle around the bony areas of your horse's body, such as their back, shoulders, hips, and don't use the rubber curry on your horse's face or legs. Another side note, while you're grooming, it's important that the tools be cleaned frequently. A curry comb that's matted with hair and dirt won't really help much with you grooming the horse. Step four, the dandy brush. This brush is used to brush off all the debris that the curry comb loosened up. It can be used on all parts of the horse's body. However, some horses with very sensitive skin may get annoyed if you brush too hard. And you want to flick this brush away and up from the coat so that the dirt comes off. Unless your horse is already extremely clean, you should see a slight cloud of dust with each stroke. If you don't, you probably need a little bit more flicking action with the brush. Step five, you want to use the body brush now. The body brush is meant to smooth down the hair and to get rid of any traces left over from or left over after the dandy brush and the curry comb. With the body brush, you don't want to use a flicking motion. It's more of a long, smooth motion used to flatten the horse's coat. And this brush is what usually gives the shiny, clean appearance. On to step six. Use the mane and tail brush to gently brush out the horse's mane. And before brushing the tail, use some detangler. I like to use Cowboy Magic, and I put about a quarter size of my hand and rub my hands together. Then I massage it into the tail. A lot of people use the mane and tail brush in their horses' tails, but I don't like to do that because it breaks the hairs more easily. If you want the horse to grow a long, flowing tail, you should use the dandy brush instead. Step seven, now onto the feet. Usually, you can pick up their feet by running your hand down the horse's leg and then gently squeezing his fetlock, but I've taught my horses to lift their leg when I tap above the inside of their knee and I say hoof. When you use the hoof pick, always scrape away from you, just as you would if you're using a carrot peeler or an apple peeler. You don't want to accidentally injure yourself or your horse if he suddenly moves or pulls his foot away, or flick poop or mud into your eye, because that's disgusting. And it's important to thoroughly clean out the grooves on each side of the frog and around the sole of the foot so your horse doesn't develop any fungus or thrush. And then step eight, the last step is using the towel. A plain towel or rag is fine. Just wipe it over the horse's coat and that'll bring out shine. Extra shiny. And voila, you're all done.